What's up, YouTube? It's Kim, and it's Way in Wednesday. I am so happy to say that I lost again this week. I was down 0.8. Yes. I am so happy about that. I had a fantastic week. My food was great. I still had a few weeklies left over. My activity was great. I got to the gym 4 times this week. 2 times I did couch to 5K, run walking. I did yoga class once and Zumba class once. So that was awesome. Felt great. And luckily it showed on the scale. So I am in the teens. I am 219.8. OMG. I am 2.2 away from my next 5-pound milestone, which is 100 pounds. It's so cool. It couldn't have been a more perfect time of year. As hard as it is this time of year, it was like perfect that this huge milestone happened at this time, because it's really, really just putting me in such a good mind frame and just so motivated to get to that milestone. And I'm loving the gym. I feel so happy there. I feel like I belong, you know? I walk around and I'm just like every other healthy person there to work out, and it feels great. So I've been loving it. So that's awesome. Today at the meeting, we talked about holiday stress. Yes, I know. Holiday stress is a beast. It really just, it does take away from the fun of the holiday, because you just think of everything that you have to do, everything that's going on. And today in the meeting, we talked about some ways to get through holiday stress. So in the meeting, one of the women said she gets on her treadmill. Another woman said she sits and read a book. Our leader will stop and clean. She said if she's cleaning windows, you know something's going down. And for me, when I'm stressed out, instead of eating, I try to make a list, get organized, because if I know I have, you know, 6,000 things to do, it helps to kind of make a list so I can start checking it off one by one. Also, if I'm stressed out, I reach out to a friend. I'll shoot someone a text message or a Facebook message. I'll go on Instagram just to kind of waste some time and get my mind off of the stress. So I would love to know, what do you guys do to kind of calm yourself down when you're stressed out and not stress eat? Now, in the weekly, which I will put the link down below, I wanted to share some of the ways they said you can bust stress instantly. Smile. Flashing a real grin can release endorphins, natural hormones that help relieve pain and give a sense of pleasure and contentment. So smile if you want to try and release some stress. It's funny, when I'm on the phone with a client at work and they're super annoying or just getting on my nerves, I'll sit there and like smile to try to like calm myself down. So I know that actually works. Breathe deeply. Taking slow deep breaths can help relax your body. All right, let's try this together. Ready, everybody? Breathe in and out. If you're at work, I know, I'm sorry, you probably can't do that. But sometimes it just take a moment, you know, just get into your zen, take a moment for yourself, breathe. And try to relax. Slow down. You're never too busy for this tactic. One study found that it can lower blood pressure and less of stress chemicals. Slowing down is kind of hard, especially when we have 8,000 things to do. But if you can do it, awesome. Think positive. Shifting attention away from the stressor and towards something you're grateful for can relax your mind and body. I am a huge, huge believer in thinking positive. It helps me tremendously. I always try to look at the glass half full, or focus on, you know, the things I can do, or, you know, the good things of a situation. So definitely try to think of the positives. If holiday stress is getting to you, maybe make a list of what you're looking forward to this holiday season. you know, all this stress is going to bring us to Christmas, and that's usually, hopefully, always a fun day with family, and you get to enjoy the fruits of your labor. And the last one, accept the situation. We're not saying to give up, but when you're in a stressful situation, think about what you can and can't change about it. So all of us are overweight. Maybe some of you watch me that are at maintenance and at goal weight. That's awesome. But most of us are overweight, and you just have to accept it. Okay, I'm overweight. I know what I have to do to change it, and I'm going to change it. Because if you give your mind that break and just accept it, it's almost like you stop fighting yourself, and then you can move along on your journey. So I know me personally, as a binge eater, once I accepted the fact that I was never going to be cured, that it can only be managed, it definitely was a shift for me. And also when I accepted the fact that I had to track every day, that tracking just had to become part of my life. There was no ways of getting around it. It was like, once I accepted that fact, I was okay. And I just make it part of my life. And Lori and I still, every night, check in with each other to make sure we call it all tracked up. And it has been amazing. I have tracked every single day for, I can't even tell you, the last time I didn't track. So tracking is huge, because when my food is in control, I'm in control. And that's definitely helping me this holiday season. Also, check out my What I Ate video that I posted on Monday. I will link that below. When I was watching it back in the morning, I had said how stressed I was. And then, if you notice, after the gym, I was in such a better mood. And the rest of the day, I had a great day. So it just went to show me that working out truly is such a stress reliever for me. I need it. I need it in my life. It is my antidepressant. I love it so much, and I'm 100% gonna keep up with my workouts, because they just make me a happier person, and happier people make healthier choices. Also, I saw a vlogger that I watched do this, and I thought it would be fun to do. Every week she answers a question from a subscriber. And I would love to answer any questions that you guys have. You can put it down in the comments below, and I will answer it in a future video. The first question I want to answer is from MJ Manchester. She asked this question a few weeks back, and she said, what will be my non-food celebration when I get to 100 pounds? So originally I wanted to go on a trip. You know, when I first started this journey, I was like, oh, when I get to 100 pounds, I'm going to go on a trip, you know, somewhere warm. Well, that's not happening, because I have a five-year-old and she's in school, and it's just not happening. So I have always wanted a pair of diamond stud earrings. So I spoke to my husband, and he is going to buy me a pair of diamond earrings when I get to 100 pounds. So I can wear those and always be reminded of my journey and that milestone. So that is the answer to that question. I'll definitely show you guys after I get them. So if you have a question for me and you'd like me to answer it in a future video, put it in the comments below. So, hope everybody has a great week. And as always, stay fit and fabulous. Bye.